India is on verge of massive urbanization boom. You'll be surprised that in 2001 census, India had 5,161 census towns, and in 2011, from 5,161 census towns, India has 7,935 census towns, a growth of around 2,800 towns has never taken place in the history of our entire independent India. And this is the verge of urbanization we are sitting on. You have to have smart cities which are vertical in nature. You can't have horizontal sprawl, low-lying cities. This is not the way the cities are growing in the world today. We need to have high-rises. We need to have cities with higher FSI. In our cities, it is unfortunate that we now are talking about FSI or FAR of 2.5, 3, 3.5, whereas globally, the FSI or FAR is double digit on which people talk about. In Singapore or in Hong Kong or in Shanghai, the FSI or FAR is double digit. It is more than 10. And here in our country, the highest FSI for group housing is 4. So you can understand how we can grow unless we have higher FSI, unless we have more compact city, when energy resources are scarce, when we need to have better transportation, we need to have people living together, we need our cities to grow up, we need cities to have mixed land use so that people can live at the same place and are able to work at the same place. These are the internationally acclaimed norms. These are the norms which are followed world over, but unfortunately they are yet to start in our country. This is something which is very important for our country, for our cities to grow in our country. Now, Sandeep was talking about regulation of real estate, something which I initiated and started when I was the Housing and Urban Poverty Alleviation Minister. This bill has been introduced in Rajya Sabha, and we hope to get it through very soon through the Parliament. Now, this Real Estate Regulatory Authority Bill, why is it important? When we had set up a group to identify the shortage of housing in our country, it calculated that there is a shortage of 18.78 million houses, whereas the total number of census households and census houses, the difference is just 0.39 million houses, just 3,90,000 million houses, which is very small. If this is a clear picture, then there is no housing shortage or there is no housing requirement in the country. But if you look at the census figures minutely, you'll find that in urban areas, 10.16% of census houses are vacant. So when we have 10.16% of houses which are vacant, and simultaneously we have 18.78 million shortfall in housing in our country, this means that there is a mismatch between the policy makers, policy making, and what is happening at the ground. The reality is that people buy these houses for speculative purposes. The reality is that our tenancy control norms, laws are such archaic that people are unwilling to give it on rent. The reality is that we have space, we have number of houses, but still people are forced to live in slum. Both are stark realities, and we need to tackle these things. And in order to tackle these things, we need to have a regulatory authority, we need to have a strong regulatory mechanism. So what we want is, first of all necessary statutory clearances should be taken before a project is launched. The second thing is, we want this ambiguity of super area, ambiguity of covered area, or ambiguity of actual carpet area to be removed. So keeping all these things in mind, we have come up with Real Estate Regulatory Authority Bill, and we are hopeful that this bill will very soon see light of the day, which would be a balanced bill. It would not be overly regulating, but through this bill, we'll be able to protect the interest of genuine buyers.